So I do want to just put on the record that while this is a lengthy video, it is 49 minutes, it's a critical, we believe, and so I just would ask you for the jurors' patience in viewing it.
There might be some boring parts, is that what you're saying?
I don't believe I do not believe there are any boring parts, but that's me.
Lulls.
I think even the reason for the entire video is even during the period where there's no conversation, it's an opportunity to view and observe the defendant. So I just want to put on the record why I'm playing the whole thing.
Okay. And Your Honor, we have no objection. We stipulate to the exhibit.
Well, in the interest of completion, too, it's going to play the whole thing. So.
Okay. Okay. All right. Sergeant Peschke, do you know about what time this starts? I mean, actually not what, about what time. Do you know what time that she gets in the car?
Not exactly. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's okay. So what, can you tell us what the time says?
It's 14:57 at that.
I mean, I know my son was the one that shot the school, so I'm not quite sure like why we're in the back of the cop car.
Well, right now, we're detaining you until the investigator can get things fixed up.
Is there like an air back here?
Yep. Were you handcuffed when they brought you on the house?
Not, well, they handcuffed me at the front door.
Okay. Well, so being that, fine, hold on. So you understand, you're not in custody, you're just, right now, we need to check your house for evidence.
That's fine.
Okay. Would you be willing to sign a form for us to do check the week when you go to your house?
Yeah.
Okay. Is his room far in the back? Is there something?
Yeah.
Okay. Is his room all the way in the back?
No, he's got, there's two pits on either side of that.
So he has two bedrooms?
Yeah, because his bedroom got so out of control, he moved into the guest room, and I got out of control, and I haven't got a chance to get it yet.
Whose room is all the way in the back?
That was mine. Me and my husband.
Okay. What's your name?
James.
Is that Ethan's dad?
Yeah.
By a line?
Yeah.
Okay. Does he own a firearm?
Yes.
Ethan does?
No.
James
does.
Did you see that box that was on your bed in the back bedroom?
I haven't had a chance to go back where that stuff.
Okay. What's a good phone number for you?
248-760-7502.
Did Ethan have a phone?
He did.
What's that?
It's stored in my phone. I don't know if I had my phone in the bumper that police vehicle, so I can get it.
Okay. And your husband's name is James?
Yes.
James, same line?
Yes.
Who's Hazor?
Who?
Hazor? No? Okay. Okay. How was your son this morning?
I left to work early, and James said we got in a fight last night, but it was great, and they were bad. And I got on to him, and stepped away from him, and this morning on the way to school, they said he seemed fine, he apologized, and it was normal, there was nothing abnormal. Nothing.
Okay.
Nothing.
He left just like normal? Did he walk?
No, James fell from school.
Okay. Oh, okay. All right. Did James hear?
He's in the back of my head, he's back there.
Yeah. When did you get home from work?
The minute he told me there was an active shooter after high school, and I couldn't get a hold of Ethan, I left. So I don't know what time it was right now.
Okay. So
we went right to the substation.
All right. So you were gone this morning before Ethan left for school.
Yeah.
And James told him. What time did you leave?
Well, wait a minute. James took him first. I woke up late this morning. I left after.
Okay. Were you sleeping in the back bedroom?
Was I sleeping in the back bedroom?
Yeah.
I mean, that's where I sleep, that's where I woke up.
Right, but, so I guess it's kind of hard for me to ask you because there's a gun box on your bed.
Yeah, that's probably when we found there's an active shooter, we were at school early this morning because the counselor found some drawings on paper and said it didn't seem a concern to stay at school. And then we found an active shooter, James came home and he looked open the gun box, said the gun's gone, and we had the bullets hidden in two separate spots and the bullets were gone. And we called Logan County and told them what we thought, and they called us down to the substation. That's where we were.
So
we just got back from there.
So you guys noticed the gun was missing this morning?
No.
So I guess explain it to me again.
Didn't know about it until we heard there was an active shooter.
Okay.
And we were just at the counter office because Ethan was drawing some, we were going to do his mom some paper. And then all of a sudden there's an active shooter. And James flew home and he's like, I had the gun hidden, and I told him where I hid the bullets, and they were both missing. So sometime, I don't know.
Well, it had to be sometime today. Did you sleep in that back bedroom?
Yeah.
So
I woke up in there, and there was nothing abnormal.
Right, but the box wasn't on your bed. Did you make your bed?
No.
Okay, so if the box is on your bed, so what I'm just trying to get a timestamp when he could have picked up the gun.
I don't think he could have. Not this morning.
Unless, do you think, is it possible that James maybe, like, checked the box for the handgun and put it on the bed?
Well, yeah, I told you. Okay. Yeah, when after we found out.
That's the part that I was
missing. Yeah, yeah, when we after we heard there was an active shooter and after what we talked to the counselor at the school today, he came here during this whole time this was going on, mm-hmm. and that's when he noticed the gun was gone. That's when he called you guys.
Okay. What kind of images was he drawing?
On my phone. I didn't look at that closely because...
Can you grab the phone?
It's on the bumper of that.
It's on the bumper of that car.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I mean, are they?
Well, now that when I was at the substation, I looked at them more closely. They're a little disturbing. Well, they're very disturbing because look what he just fucking did.
Okay.
Sorry.
No.
I don't even know what the hell I'm thinking. I'm kind of in shock. Like, he's never been in trouble. He's never done anything. Like, he's never done anything wrong. He's a good kid.
Right. Well, we are too.
This is fucked up.
Yeah. So.
Like, my son just ruined his life. I'll probably never see him again. Like, what the fuck?
Right. How old is he?
15.
I'm sorry.
I'm not gonna
people. No. I wouldn't. The green one?
Yeah.
I'm going to take a picture of this, okay? Is this on the homework?
It was on a math assignment that they were supposed to turn in.
What did he say when you started talking to him today at the council?
He said he was sorry that we lost a dog. His best friend got sent to an OCD facility treatment thing, and my mother-in-law passed away, and he said he's dealing with a lot of stress, and he was just putting thoughts on paper. It's the first time we've ever seen anything like this, or he's ever been
involved. You've never seen anything like this before?
No, and he's never, like, he's, I don't know.
Do you know that he knows how to, like, handle a firearm?
Yeah, because we take him to the gun range.
Okay. You teach him how to
handle firearms? That's our hobby, that we go to the gun range, and that's what we do.
Is that the only gun you have in the house?
Well, the one, aside from the one that you took to the school, yes. There's like BB guns, but.
There's BB guns, and then I think it was a 45 caliber that was at the school.
That was a 9mm.
A 9?
It should have been.
But you don't have it, like,
there's,
what is it, Glock?
No, it's a SIG something.
Okay, a SIG.
Which we just got fucking Sunday. Friday. And we took them to the gun range so they can...
Oh, you just bought it?
Yeah, I mean, we've had another one for a long time.
Okay. What was the other one?
It's my husband knows. I don't know.
No, yeah,
it's a 22, I think.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
And then we went out and we...
He had bad grades, but
they're not horrible. You just have to know that the geometry got to an E. I mean, I'm not a math expert. I just told him to get a D minus on math.
Right.
And then, I looked on his power school last night, and I saw an E, and I said, so your grade gets brought back up. There's no gun range, or no phone, there's no nothing. I looked at those two trigger points. And then he was mad last night. This morning, he seemed fine.
Okay.
It's not the first time he's been in trouble for his grades.
Right. Okay.
I mean, he's he was a good kid.
Right.
Like, he just doesn't do anything. He, like, stays at the house, and I don't know. He loves his animals, and I never would have.
Well, I'm not. I mean, I don't think he's a bad kid.
I think you might have been upset about something today.
He's never exerted any type of anger, he's never exerted anything. Like, he's just like one of those mellow, laid back kids. Mm-hmm. We've always had an open, and he'll talk about stuff. Like, I don't get it.
Right.
I don't get what happened.
Okay. Well, like you said, what grade was he in there?
You're not going to release his name on the news, are there?
It won't be for a while, but this is, I'm sure your neighbors are already talking.
Right. I got handcuffed outside my front door. That was great.
Yeah. Crumbley.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys own her?
I water in it as well.
Oh, what? It's all good.
Yeah, my biggest fear with the A's and turning it down myself.
I Yep. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you.
might take a little while. But what I'm going to do, I didn't realize you'd already talked to a sergeant earlier. So with all the chaos going on, I have a little bit of a misunderstanding on everybody's part. So what I'm going to do, I can't technically let you go back in the house because they want to do a search warrant. So what I can do is if you guys want to go get a cup of coffee, go get a drink, leave. Sergeant Brian said he will call you as soon as the search warrant is done on your house. But I can't let you go back in right now. So I don't know, that's what Detective Stoyak is also calling your husband. I don't know if you need heavy car keys. No? But you don't keep guns in the car? Okay. So, yeah, I mean, do you want to think about it for a second or wait until your husband or...
I'm going to let you make the decision.
Yeah, I think.